How's it going, people? Today I'm going to be talking you through the top 5 cheap sleeper cars that you can buy for under £5,000. When I say sleeper car, I mean the type of car that looks like it shouldn't be that quick, but when you actually start to drive it, it absolutely goes. The types of cars that are going to win the traffic light Grand Prix regardless of what car you come up against. Well, not regardless, but you know what I mean. And because this video is all about pace, I've ordered them from 0 to 60, so from slowest to fastest. This has been a hugely asked for video by you guys, and I really wanted to deliver on it, so here it is, and I'm sorry that it's a day late. Remember that I make these videos from the UK market perspective, so prices in other countries may differ. And also remember that whenever you buy any form of secondhand car, particularly high performance ones, maintenance, repairs, insurance, and road tax are really important to remember when actually considering buying a car. As always, remember to comment down below to let me know if I've missed anything or if you have any thoughts on the video and that kind of stuff. Sorry in advance for my voice, I have a really sore throat, so I can't really do much about that. But as always, remember to like and subscribe for more weekly car content. And without further ado, let's get into the video. Starting us off at number 5 with the second generation Lexus SC430, a rear-wheel drive grand tourer that hosts a 4.3-litre V8 engine that puts out 282 brake horsepower, taking it from 0 to 60 in just 6.2 seconds. The original concept for the first generation SC was that it would be a competitor to other fast cars in its class, like the Mercedes-Benz SL, while simultaneously remaining a luxury vehicle. It is for this reason that they called it the SC, which actually stands for Sport Coupe. Combining sports and luxury is a great foundation for a sleeper, as what can look like quite a sedate and chilled out car can still blitz it off the lights. And Lexus definitely didn't skimp out on either the sports or luxury side of their design brief. In terms of sports, the car has also been used in GT motorsports races, using a modified version of the standard engine which puts out over 500 brake horsepower. In fact, the SC430 won its debut Super GT race in the opening round at Suzuka. It has also been seen in Formula Drift, that was powered by a 2JZ engine. In terms of luxury, the designers actually took a trip to the south of France to develop the shape of the car, loosely basing the character lines of the car's exterior on the yachts they saw. To be honest, maybe they were just pulling a fast one to get a free holiday to the French Riviera, but the car still shouldn't look too out of place driving along the coast with the roof down. You can pick up a high mileage SC430 for a minimum of around £2,700, but 5 grand will get you a well looked after example with around 90k miles on the clock. In terms of reliability, there have been a few reports of head gasket failures because of low coolant levels, and leaking fluids from the radiator to the gearbox, and vice versa. The vapor canister is an expensive failure too, so be aware of this, as well as the water pump. Unless the transmission fluid has been contaminated, you can expect the automatic gearbox to run pretty well, and other than that, repairs are generally more based on wear and tear to different parts of the car based on age. So there we have it, the Lexus SC430 is a nice, sedate looking alternative to the Mercedes-Benz SL class that can put down a serious 0-60 time. Coming in at number 4 we have the first generation front wheel drive Mazda 3 MPS, also known as the Mazda Speed 3 in other markets, which has a 2.3-litre inline 4 turbocharged engine, putting out 256 brake horsepower, taking it from 0-60 in just 5.9 seconds. Though to the naked eye this may just look like a slightly more flared version of the Mazda 3, it packs some very desirable features to make it one of the best performing cars at this price range, such as a limited slip diff as standard, traction control and dynamic stability control, as well as additional structural bracing to massively improve the handling. And to show that this really is a proper hot hatch, you can turn off the TC and DSC if you fancy throwing the car around with some more freedom. The car has received a huge amount of love from the car world. The engine was listed in Ward's 10 best engines for 3 years straight, while Edmund said the car is comparable to the more expensive rivals like the Evo and STI. Car and driver actually measured the 0-60 at 5.4 seconds as well, despite official time suggesting the car is half a second slower. This means you can properly expect to turn some heads with the pace of this car, even if it doesn't look like a track weapon. You can pick up a high mileage example for around 3 grand, but 5k will get you a model with around 65,000 miles on the clock, making this by far the lowest mileage car you can buy on this list. The car is also considered to be incredibly reliable, with few engine or turbo related issues being reported. You should of course look out for certain warning signs though, in terms of the VVT actuator rattling, worn turbo seals, notchy first to second gear changes, and one key issue, make sure the engine mounting bolt isn't loose, as some were recalled due to this issue, which can cause the drive shaft to detach. Anyway, a great little hot hatch sleeper, and in my opinion probably the best value for money you'll get on this list in terms of performance, features, mileage, and reliability. Onto the top three now, and in third place we have the rear-wheel drive E90 BMW 335D, which hosts a 3-litre twin-turbo diesel inline-six engine that puts out 281 brake horsepower, taking it from 0 to 60 in around 5.7 seconds. This is the fifth generation of a well-renowned 3 Series that BMW has been putting out since 1975, and continues a theme of a generally boxy and understated styling while simultaneously having some serious specs. The 335D has the largest engine for any of the diesel models available, and can be bought in a saloon, estate, coupe and convertible option, as well as in both M-Sport and non-M-Sport variants. I think if you're really looking for that sleeper look, you need to get yourself an estate, as you have a highly practical and functional car that can still dominate the roads in terms of performance. On top of this, the 335D is a particularly useful sleeper in that it can average around 40 to 44 miles per gallon, meaning more money in your pocket. As with most BMWs, the car comes with some nice luxury features too in order to ensure you remain comfortable whilst crushing the miles, like heated leather seats and comfort entry. But let's not forget that the car isn't all sedate, as there is of course the E90 M3 available, as well as the SI, which was created to satisfy the FIA World Touring Car Championship homologation rules. The E90 actually won over 35 races and 2 championships in the series. You can pick up a high mileage 335D for around 3.5 grand, but 5k will get you a decent example with around 90,000 miles on the clock. Some owners of the car have been disappointed with its reliability, but having been through a lot of forums and articles, I noticed the majority of owners seem pretty happy with the car, with a lot of people racking up huge mileages with only minor issues. However, there is a suggestion that when something does go wrong, it really can be an expensive fix, due to pricey BMW maintenance fees. Watch out for leaks from the change airline which leads from the turbos to the intercooler, as this is a common issue. Overall though, the 335D offers practicality, performance, and to an extent, reliability, so is well worth its title as a sleeper. In second place we have the second generation Haldex all-wheel drive Volvo V70R, which is a 2.5 litre turbocharged 5-cylinder engine, which puts out 300 brake horsepower, taking it from 0 to 60 in around 5.6 seconds. Not bad at all for an old estate. Now this is a proper sleeper, as many have slated Volvo for making boring cars in the past, but I feel you'd be hard pressed to find a car for the price that looks this understated but goes as quickly as it does. It includes some very decent features that allows for this performance, including Brembo brakes, Öhlins multi-mode suspension, twin intercoolers and 6-speed manual transmission. Funnily enough, despite being from Sweden, the V70 was actually designed by a British designer who described the car as having the front end of an E-Type Jag married to the back end of a Ford Transit van. In an article by the Wall Street Journal titled The Man Wagon, they suggested that the V70R was built to lure in speed crazy guys with kids, and that Volvo were looking to transform the boring old family estate into something new. They based it on some consumer research which had found that family men believed estates could be really cool if only they had more power, which definitely resonates with me as I love a fast estate. It must be said that there aren't many V70Rs for less than £5,000, but they are available, and as the engine is considered to be pretty reliable, the issues you'd likely be facing would be related to the wear and tear of the car rather than the engine going wrong. This is something that owners on forums confirm. That engine block is very solid. However, one area that could potentially cause hassle is the tyre wear, which happens particularly unevenly. Some have even noted switching their front and rear tyres up to 5,000 miles to ensure even tyre wear, otherwise one pair just gets ruined. Another issue is the transfer box, which some owners have had significant issues with, and cost over a grand to fix, so be wary of this. Overall though, the V70R is potentially a classic Volvo, with quite a strong cult following, and though it may look quite unassuming, it will rinse the competition away from the lights. Finally, taking the top spot, we have the surprisingly rare W203 Mercedes-Benz C32 AMG, which is a 3.2-litre V6 supercharged engine that puts out 354 brake horsepower, taking it from 0 to 60 in just 5.2 seconds, annihilating the other cars in this list. Now, when I said this car is rare, one particular version of it remains almost entirely impossible to find, which is the Sport Coupe. This was only available in 2003 as a special request to AMG Studio, and production numbers are as of yet unknown. Instead, you're most likely to find a saloon, or in some cases a limited run estate, which I think is probably the coolest and most sleeper looking version of the car. Interesting that Mercedes decided to go for this V6 option, as both its predecessor and successor used a V8 engine instead. This is probably part of the reason why the car is sometimes considered to be a failed experiment by Mercedes, but that's not to say it's not a high performing car. as that twin-screw supercharger ensures it is not lacking in the power department. This reputation of being a failed experiment is also likely the reason why the car is available for less than 5 grand. The cheapest I saw had over 100,000 miles and was listed for around £3,300, though the 5k mark will bag you a car with around 90k on the clock. In terms of reliability, owners suggest the car is generally mechanically sound, and that the majority of issues are due to its poor build quality in certain places, accruing rust and cracks. Some owners have noted issues like a leaking fuel hose, blown intercooler, and a few other problems. The average service for a generally healthy car is expected to be around £600 annually, so not too much, but worth keeping in mind. Anyway, even if this car is a little bit of an awkward and inadequate sibling to the C63 AMG, you can't argue with the figures. 0-60 in 5.2 seconds in a sleeper-looking estate Mercedes will most certainly have that. So to recap, I've given you my take on the top 5 cheap sleeper cars you can buy for under £5,000. Remember to comment down below to let me know if I've missed any cars, or if I've got anything wrong, or if I've got anything right. Just any comments are more than welcome. Thank you so much for all the support recently, I've really appreciated it, and I'm super sorry that this video is a day late. It's simply because I had Skepta on Wednesday, Christmas party on Thursday, and Christmas party on Friday, so just got right in my schedule of making videos, and obviously I've been kind of ill, hence the really, really weird voice, so sorry about that as well. But as always, thank you very much for watching. Like and subscribe for more weekly car content, and I will see you in the next one.